One of the places that puts Portland, Maine on the world food map is a Mexican barbecue place called Terlingua.
Ooh.
And I get to have lunch with a local band called the Ghost of Paul Revere.
Well, I'm a new man now, one of you should know.
This is the ghost of Paul Revere right here.
Hey, what's going on?
I'm the ghost of what used to be Phil Rosenthal.
Nice to meet you, man.
I want you to meet Griffin, Sean, Chuck, and Max.
Did you bring your instruments? Because it's not a free meal, you know.
We're used to that.
Yeah?
That's it.
Yeah. We'll work for food.
Yeah, exactly. We've been doing it for
and margaritas.
So.
And where do you go from here?
Yep. Rehearsal.
I was walking down the street and I smelled this, so I'm very excited. I want to hear all about the band.
Is there a lead singer?
No, we kind of do three-part harmonies for all the songs and trade off leads.
It's a pretty good deal. We've known each other for 31 years.
Yeah. What, since you're babies?
Yeah. Pretty much.
Not for me so much.
Oh, yeah. We found Chuck later, but we were preschool buddies together, and we grew up through elementary school and middle school and high school together.
There's a lot of pictures of us with vacuums and brooms pretending
banging
to play guitar.
Them.
Yeah.
That's adorable.
Yeah.
So how old were you when you thought, hey, we can do music?
And then we went off to college and kind of came back all and lived in Portland after college, and that's when the band started. Oh, we also were playing music like a half hour from where we grew up, so often our moms would also be there too, so like.
That's who came to my shows.
Yep, great.
Mom and her friends.
Yeah.
Oh, I was swinging. Oh, baby, oh, baby, oh, baby.
Gentlemen, the Terlingua barbecue boards. Texas style beef brisket, adobo chicken, a big, massive beef rib.
I always call the beef ribs pot roast on a stick.
Oh. Lamb ribs, Texas hot link sausage, and some house cornbread.
I'm going
Please
in.
Please enjoy.
Thank you.
Wow.
Holy moly. Hot knife?
Yeah.
Lamb ribs, eh?
Look how cute they are. Mmm.
You grew up here. When did Portland become such a food city?
I mean, I feel like that's been in the last like 10 years. The food in this town is kind of out of control and getting more so every year.
Hard to keep up with.
It's
very
hard to keep up
with. You go away on tour and you come back and there's six new restaurants.
Right. Yeah.
We've got enough farmers and artisans around here who are making all these delicious cheeses and meats and breads and stuff like that.
Yeah.
It only made sense for them to get involved into the restaurant game.
Right.
And then once people felt comfortable enough and had the confidence that people were willing to pay for these things, then it turned into this kind of movement and we get to reap all the spoils.
That's right.
Out of places we've traveled, it's like, that's why I always end up coming home.
Max, here's what I want you to do. Grab that, like a handle.
I love you.
Oh, it's that's like you at the Freiburg Fair. Look at that.
Fantastic. Mm-hmm.
We are cavemen.
Yeah.
Take a corner. Very good. Beautiful.
Oh, good grip.
Ugh.
Nice one.
Wow.
That's it.
Oh, dude. Oh, man. You almost got the
whole thing. Whoa. Got the meat string.
This is going to be good.
Yes.
Done. Oh, yeah.
Oh, man.
This is why you're the ghost of Paul Revere.
Exactly.
The eaters are coming. The eaters are coming.
Yeah.
You never want to have a heavy lunch. You want a light lunch so that you can continue the day.
Exactly. That's what a siesta's for, actually.
Yeah.
Can we turn rehearsal into nap time?
Everything's going to be halftime.
And then you'll be like, you know what? This song does sound better like this.
Good.